my day. فضوا عندك. We have our elder brother, our brother عبد الرحمن from الصومال. Now he's in Akona Hospital, room number 5331. Please, if you have time, you should visit him. Why we have to visit him? Number one is, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حق المسلم على المسلم خمس. Has right. We should visit him because it's right. We should visit our brother if he's sick. Number two, mashallah, he's elder than us and he's very good brother Muslims. Mashallah, may Allah accept inshallah from him. And number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of resurrection, he said, عبدي مرضت فلم تعودني. فقال العبد كيف أعودك وأنت رب العالمين؟ قال أما علمت أن عبدي فلان مرض فلم تعده؟ يبقى الله سبحانه وتعالى الله أو مجلسته الله سبحانه وتعالى said oh my servant and hereafter imagine when you stand before God no clothes no money nothing and he will ask you why didn't you visit me when I was sick he said and or reply how come I visit you and you are my lord he said you don't know my servant so and so is sick why didn't you visit him And please, if you heard anyone sick, try visit him. And listen to our scholar said, we have category about many, many kinds about sick people. Number one is Muslim, not practice. We should visit him to make da'wah. And another one, Muslim, he practices with you. And the Muslim, poor. You should visit and help him and support him by financial, some money. Some Muslim is very sick and has children. Imagine now, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send the shifa to many brothers around us. Wallahi, I visited last week, brother. I don't want to mention his name. He has three children. No English. Why? His wife, no English. And he stayed in his home almost 3 months now. May Allah help him. Wallahi, if you visit brother, this kind of situation, Please support him, give him anything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you more, for sure. And number four, non-Muslim. Imagine in Al-Bukhari, okay, very strong hadith, Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu narrated, said, Marida ghulaman yahudiyan kana yakhdimu al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The young from Jewish was sick. The end from Jewish, he was servant to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did? He said, yes, he's Jewish? No, wallahi. Because alayhi salatu wa sallam, Allah said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ Muslim or non-Muslim. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went to visit who? Ghulam, young boy from Jewish, alayhi salatu wa sallam. When he visited him, he said next to his head, فقال له يا غلام قل لا إله إلا الله say لا إله إلا الله والله صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم the best word we can say say لا إله إلا الله and may Allah protect us from show off إن شاء الله لا إله إلا الله special when the soul go out إن شاء الله have guarantee we go paradise may Allah help us to say لا إله إلا الله آمين يا رب العالمين And the young boy, the ghulam, is afraid from his father. And he looked at his father, and his father very polite. He's Jewish, but very polite. He said, Oh my son, ati' Aba al-Qasim. Obey Aba al-Qasim. Kuniti Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also very respectful to Prophet Muhammad. Alayhi salatu wa sallam. They say, Obey Muhammad? No. Ati' Aba al-Qasim. And the young boy say, he said, لا إله إلا الله and he did. What Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did? He's very happy. He said, الحمد لله الذي أنقذه من النار بي. He said, Oh praise to Allah سبحانه وتعالى because Allah protected him from hellfire by me. What about you and me? If you heard, please, anyone is sick, you should visit him. And I will tell you the last moment in Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم his life. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Last day, not anyone, you know, some condition, the old relative can't come. And when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very sick, only Ali can visit him. And the companion asked Ali, the Hadith al-Bukhari also, Ya Aba al-Hasan, كيف حال النبي sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? You know, the last moment is very, very hard. And Aba al-Hasan said, he's better now, alhamdulillah. You must encourage all people, encourage, say good news. And our mother Aisha said, مات النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بين سحري ونحري. When Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away, I hug him and his head here in this area from our mother Aisha. And she heard him. He said, اللهم, listen, who said that? Prophet Muhammad صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اللهم اغفر لي وارحمني وإلى الرفيق الأعلى. Wow. Listen and learn from Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. Last moment, don't think about your sins. Think only about رحمة الله. أنا عند ظن عبدي بي, only think about جنة. Don't think about the fire. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اللهم اغفر لي. And you should memorize this. Very easy. Oh Allah, forgive me. وارحمني. Say, وارحمني. وإلى الرفيق الأعلى. الرفيق الأعلى, some scholars said, all prophets, as Prophet Yusuf عليه السلام said, وأدخلني برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين أو مع عبادك المسلمين, يبقى أول الملائكة. يبقى لابد, we must learn from Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. And also the etiquette, don't said too much time. إن شاء الله tomorrow shall we visit our brother عبد الرحمن, إن شاء الله في half time tomorrow. After عصر we'll visit him. And if you visit him, put your hand in his head. Say, نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش العظيم أن يشفيك. 7 times. Okay? And another will say, آمين. One time, Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام visited Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, and Sa'd was very, very sick. And the Prophet Muhammad raised his hand and said, اللهم اشفي سعدة, اللهم اشفي سعدة, اللهم اشفي سعدة. Oh Allah, cure Sa'd. Make any dua. Don't say too much time, except if the brother said, please, sit down. Okay? Wallah, when I was in hospital, some brother visit to me and he sleep. What are you doing? Why are you coming? You want to sleep? Go to your room. Okay? Visit. Brother, you must prepare your intention. Think of Allah. And you know why? Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, if you visit anyone who's sick, 70,000 angels, they pray upon you. If you visit in the night, 70,000 angels pray upon you until morning. And if you visit in the day, 70,000 angels pray upon you until evening. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us our understanding our Quran and our religion, inshaAllah. And the follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send him as a rahmah to al-alameen. Muslim or non-Muslim, jinn or human. فضلنا. جزاك الله خير. صلى الله عليه وسلم.